A digital innovator uses the appropriate tool at the appropriate time. Sometimes technology is not the best tool for the day. A paper and pencil are. It's important to keep that in mind. Trying to force a lesson into technology can steal time from the classroom. Digital innovation allows teachers to provide more detailed and personalized instruction. I still write some comments on the paper, and I use a rubric to score, but I upload the voice comments, reading back sections of the paper to the student so they can hear the corrections. Using a digital portfolio, I can personalize it for the students. This student was DJing a school event, and we just snapped a selfie together. Quick upload on her page, and it's personalized even more. If I'm going to give students feedback, I should be willing to listen to theirs. After listening to my comments and uploading to their portfolio, students click on this link. By using this form, students can provide me with immediate feedback, which helps me to clarify any questions and tailor my feedback to the individual learner. I can also adjust my teaching for the next day based on any questions or concerns they might have. I always ask what steps they took in order to clarify any lapses in my instruction. We may assume that kids will reach out for help when they are confused, but that's not always the case. Many are much more comfortable asking questions digitally than raising their hands in class. This gives them the voice. It also provides them a nudge to take care of their own learning when they have a question. The technology will change, so innovators make it a practice to ask their students how they would like the content delivered. Based on their suggestions this year, I created a YouTube channel to upload complex lessons. I teach it in class, and the students can review it at home. If a student's absent, they have access to the same lesson. In a blended model, students watch the video before coming to class. This allows me to meet with them in small groups, allowing more time for them to collaborate with each other and with me. Tweeting out class activities connects the students to each other, the lesson, and it connects families to the classroom. Using programs like Remind help me to remind students of important upcoming assignments and deadlines, and again, it connects families to the classroom as well. Parents and mentors want to help their students. Innovation gives them a tool to do so. Technology allows innovators to leverage classroom time. PBS has amazing resources like Shakespeare Uncovered. In the past, this video would require a full hour of instruction. Now I can assign it at home, send the link out through Facebook, Twitter, and Remind, and document who's watched the video, and then spend the next time in discussion of it. As long as I am clear about my expectations for the media, what notes to take, what questions to answer, students can come ready to discuss. We don't use valuable collaboration time watching the video. Innovation does not require a room full of technology. Leverage the technology the students already have. Most students have a mini computer, a cell phone in their pocket. By working in small groups, everyone can be involved. So here, students are practicing for an upcoming speech. One student records the speaker using the speaker's own phone so he can listen to the speech later. The other student scores the practice speech using the rubric. The scorer becomes familiar with the elements of the rubric and provides oral feedback to the speaker. Then they rotate. But it is important to remember that not all students have access to technology. We have to know our students and not put them in an awkward situation. And also, it's important that moving forward, our schools and communities provide for those students who do not have access to technology. Innovators are current, paying attention to what is trending with students, and when possible and appropriate, find ways to connect those trends to the classroom. Most English teachers touch on satire. Well, memes are visual rhetoric and often a form of satire. We can study the current trending memes, identify the most pressing social issues, and try to create our own meme. It's a great way to teach the difference between sarcasm and irony and the different forms of satire. Using modern forms of satire does not mean that we stop teaching the classics. I'm still going to teach Jonathan Swift's modest proposal, but a quick internet search of his famous essay reveals that many modern writers are also referencing it. Whenever possible, teachers need to take a seat and let the students lead the class. The technology allows the student to become the teacher. When we prepare the lesson and then turn it over to the students, it's amazing what they can do.